Like many students in Paris, Marius often studied in the Luxembourg Gardens. He noticed that the young ladies often gave him a second look, and this made him feel both shy and furious. He thought they were staring at his shabby clothes, laughing at him. The fact is, they were struck by his engaging silhouette, and they dreamed about him. One day, on a neighboring bench, there always comes a day when the gaze of a girl has the strange power of breeding deep in a boy's soul a dark flower, bursting with a perfume and poison, a flower called love. The next day, at the same time, she was there again. So was Marius. He'd lost a button on his coat, his shoes were dirty, and he didn't dare follow her. The girl and the elderly gentleman lived in a secluded house on the Rue Plumet, where they were known as Monsieur Fauchelevent and his daughter. He was often seen working in the garden. From a classmate who was better off than he, Marius borrowed a suit, gloves, and a hat. On that same day, she had put on a new dress.
She's looking at me. If I dared, I'd get up and walk past her. Her father's looking at me, too. I'd like to be handsome, to leave a medal, to be on horseback. I look ridiculous.
What a ceremonious young man he is.
That young man?
Well, who else? Cosette, what are you dreaming about?
Nothing.
Monsieur Fauchelevent chose another lane in the park, but Marius followed suit. Monsieur Fauchelevent came alone. The next day, the bench remained unoccupied. The following day, too. And every day after that. And so did every other bench on which he had ever seen her sit.